Welcome back to story time. All of you must have celebrated Dashera or Vijayadashami with great devotion. But did you know that the same day is also considered to be the day of Vidyarambha, or the day when little children who wish to begin their studies are formally initiated into the letters of the alphabet. This is also known as Saraswati Puja, or the prayer and worship of Mother Goddess Saraswati, who is the goddess of learning. In your schools, you might have noticed that in the library or the entrance, there is always an image or an idol of Mother Goddess Saraswati, because she denotes the highest wisdom. She is that form of the mother who is the teacher, who bestows knowledge upon us. So today, let us hear her story. Saraswati means the one who bestows the sara, or the essence of swa, oneself, that is the true knowledge about oneself. It is said that once when Brahmaji was sitting in the process of creation of the three worlds, one of the beautiful forms that came out in front of him was that of Goddess Saraswati. She was so beautiful that the creator himself was enchanted by his creation. Many times we have seen that an artist always keeps admiring his masterpiece. And a similar thing happened here. Instead of proceeding with the rest of the creation, Lord Brahmaji became so captivated that he kept on staring at her. So the goddess began to move a little bit on the right. At that point of time, a head sprouted on the right of Brahmaji. When she went to the left, another head sprouted to the left. When she went behind him, a fourth head came there and began looking at this beautiful creation. Now, Goddess Saraswati did not want to be the cause of distraction of Brahmaji, so she began to ascend higher and higher. But a fifth head sprouted on the top and Brahmaji continued to look at her. Finally, Goddess Saraswati approached Lord Shiva and she requested him to bring Lord Brahmaji back to the focus and begin the task of creation. Lord Shiva immediately realized that something drastic had to be done to bring Lord Brahmaji back to his task of creation. And so, taking his Trishul, he chopped off the fifth head of Brahmaji. And that is how we now know that Brahmaji is known to have four heads. Now Goddess Saraswati stood in front of him as the goddess of wisdom. And Brahmaji, realizing that he had to continue with his given task, accepted her as his consort. Now, for creating anything, knowledge is needed. And this knowledge was provided by the Vedas, which came out of Ma Saraswati. Brahmaji began to chant the Vedas, and with Goddess Saraswati by his side, the creation began to unfold. It is indeed a right combination that a four-headed Brahma with so much of intelligence contained in his four heads and Goddess Saraswati, the goddess of wisdom, sit together and they are responsible for the creation of the beautiful universe. Mother Saraswati is also known as the goddess of speech, for she is the one who resides on the tip of everybody's tongue. She is the one who brings out the thoughts in us as words. She is that divine power in us because of which we are able to think, formulate words and actually speak. We have always seen that Mother Saraswati is dressed very simply in white, because the goddess of wisdom and learning is beyond riches and material wealth. One does not have to be very showy if one is actually wise and knowledgeable. Mother Saraswati also carries a veena in her hands to signify the beautiful music that comes out when a person is truly knowledgeable. Now, as Lord Brahmaji and Mother Saraswati sat in Brahmaloka, once the earth was ravaged by a huge fire. It is known as the Vadavagni. And this could have engulfed the entire earth and the universe would have been destroyed. And so all the gods approached Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva told that there was only one person who would be able to take this fire and deliver it into the ocean so that the earth would be saved. And this would be Goddess Saraswati. She would have the wisdom to be able to take the fire that can destroy and take it and deposit it into a place where it would never be seen or could never hurt anyone. Just like a wise person knows when to control one's tongue so that fiery speech is avoided and others' feelings are taken care of. So now all the devatas approached Mother Goddess Saraswati. She took permission from Lord Brahmaji and then decided to transform herself into a river. So she went to ask advice from Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva told her that just as Mother Ganga came as a river flowing down from my locks, you too should become a river. That will be the best way for you to carry this terrible fire. And you can originate from the holy fig tree or the plaksha tree. Hearing this and accepting the advice from Lord Shiva, Goddess Parvati descended to the earth. She went into the hermitage of sage Uttanaka. There Lord Shiva gave her that fire which she would have to carry and deposit it safely. Goddess Saraswati now decided to change her form. And she merged with the plaksha tree and came out as a rivulet. She started flowing north and reached the place of Pushkar, which we know is very famous for the worship of Lord Brahmaji. It is said that anybody drinking water from the lakes at Pushkar gets a straight entry into Brahmaloka. And so the river Saraswati flowed on, carrying with her this huge responsibility that had been entrusted to her. Soon she reached the ocean and deposited the fire safely there and saved the entire earth. This is how Goddess Saraswati, as the goddess of learning or as the river or as the speech on our tongue, is always there to protect us. For the one who bestows knowledge, for the one who protects us from misfortune, is the true mother. So the next time we look at that simple, gentle form of Mother Saraswati, holding the veena in her hands, the book of scriptures, the japamala, let us remember that compared to all the material wealth in the world, knowledge is the highest. That is what we ought to strive for. I hope you liked today's story and I hope Mother Saraswati's blessings are ever upon all of us. I will be back with another story next Thursday. Until we meet again, Hari Om!